Hi there, welcome to my course. In this lecture you will learn about pen test matrix. Quantitative analysis. When using quantitative analysis, we rely on numbers and lots of them. If we can obtain measurable data, we can then extract statistics to determine the probability of an event occurring within a network. This figure is an example of how to obtain quantitative data, which we can use to analyze for patterns. Data can be gathered from log files or monitoring systems, which can be filtered to identify the frequency of events. An example of how quantitative analysis can be used to create a risk matrix would be in scanning attacks, which are often prelude to more serious and focused attacks. Firewalls and intrusion detection systems can be configured to identify and log the origination and frequency of scanning attacks against corporate networks and systems. Qualitative analysis. Qualitative risk analysis relies strictly on measurable data. If the quantitative analysis indicated that most scan attacks originated from China, it would not surprise most people. However, in real-world risk assessments, if the analysis indicated that most scan attacks originated elsewhere that are contrary to expectations, the findings would most likely be questioned and probably discarded. Examining data strictly on experience or instincts falls within qualitative analysis. This figure illustrates one example of how real-world matrix can be obtained using qualitative analysis. The analyst can ask knowledgeable individuals what they believe is the current threat a risk poses, which is then compiled and translated into risk matrix. The advantage with qualitative analysis is that subject matter experts may have unique insight into problems that raw data may not reflect. Mixed method analysis. In many cases, the use of just one method to determine matrix is insufficient. When the use of quantitative or qualitative analysis by itself does not provide solid matrices, it is possible to combine both methods to obtain the needed results. In the figure, we see one method of conducting a mixed method analysis. The data gathered from firewalls and IDS may suggest a particular plan of attack to prevent more complex attacks in the immediate future. By gathering that data and letting subject matter experts examine the information for relevancy, the experts may identify additional controls that need to be incorporated into the network defensive appliances. For instance, if the scanning attacks came from an unexpected location, such as Antarctica, the experts may be able to recognize that the attack was being relayed through a compromised network in Antarctica rather than originating from the continent. Expert judgment, also known as the Delphi method. Expert judgment uses subject matter experts to understand risk using qualitative analysis. This figure is an example of the process. Stage 1 involves submitting a questionnaire to subject matter experts, requesting their input on the level of a risk. Once the subject matter experts provide their input, the data is provided to the researcher anonymously as stage 2. The researcher can then compile the data and submit the findings back to the experts for their input, depending on how disparate the findings are. The researcher may ask the experts to provide additional input on the composite feedback. This loop of composing feedback and resubmitting to the experts can occur multiple times until the risk matrix is well defined. By requiring the anonymity of results, unbiased opinions can be collected by the researcher, even if they are contrary to the best interest of the customer or client.